Welcome back to Triple Eight Reviews. Today we're going to have the first in a three-part series of videos going through some accessories, spare parts, and replacement parts that I've purchased from Bambu Labs in order to maintain my own printer. I've noticed that there are some sales on at the moment, and I thought this is a good opportunity to go through some of these accessory parts and let everybody see what exactly you get for your money and is it worth buying in the first place. I've included the table of contents for each of the three videos, so you can skip through the video if you want to. Please like, share, and subscribe, and enjoy the video. Thanks. Welcome back to Triple Eight Reviews. Today, I'm going to take a look at some of the accessories you can purchase from Bambu Labs. This is not a sponsored video. None of these parts have been supplied to me for free. I've purchased all of these items with my own money. I purchased them after I've purchased the printer in order to help me operate the printer without any issues or downtime. So I like to keep accessories around, so I generally purchase them. So last night I saw a tweet from Bambu Labs about selling accessory kits. And while I purchased those things from Prusa in the past for my Prusa Mark III, in the case of Bambu Labs, I've purchased accessories as and when I thought I needed them. I thought I'd keep a little bit of a stock. So because I have them here, I'll take the opportunity to go through them with you and maybe give you a little bit of insight as to what you get when you purchase these things. I'm not going to talk about prices because the prices are the prices on the website and they change. So, you know, if you want to know what the price of these things are, just go to the website and take a look. But generally, they're priced well. And generally, if you're buying a number of items, you get free shipping. So it's not too bad. And there are items here that can be purchased from other suppliers. So if you can get it from other suppliers cheaper, well, then do that. That's a better place to get it. Again, as I say, this is not a sponsored video, nor is it an advertisement for Bambu Labs. It's really just for users to see what do you get when you purchase these things. So we start off with something simple, something that generally you need if you're going to have a Bambu Labs printer, and actually comes in the box when you purchase the printer as well, and that's the glue stick. So the glue stick for the build plate. Now you can purchase these anywhere. They're available from many, many suppliers. Not going to spend too much time on it, but it's a standard glue stick. We've all seen them before. These are quite handy to have and generally keep a stock of them. But what isn't so common is this. So this is the adhesive, strong adhesive from Bambu Labs. I did purchase this, but realistically I've never used it. I have seen some reviews of people using it, and it has been been hit and miss for them. In some cases it's worked really well, and in some cases it hasn't. Again, I haven't felt the need to use it, so I don't really believe that it's something that you should waste your money on unless you actually have a need for it. I bought it because I was buying other things, so I thought, well, I'll just get it and see what it's like. But I've never used it. So next up we have the activated carbon air filter. So this filter is kind of necessary. This is, goes into the cabinet of the carbon X1, and it stops fumes from getting out. I don't know how effective it is, but these things are due to be replaced every couple of hundred prints, so you need to have a few of these in stock. So it's worthwhile buying a couple and just keeping them handy. So I have about five or six of them, just in case. This one here, it's not really necessary. It's just I have a lot of PTFE tube just in case it wears out. So I also purchased their PTFE twin connectors. I actually had an interest in a project I might use these for. So I purchased them, but they're not necessary. I wouldn't waste your money on them unless you have some particular reason. The one you have in the device should work for now. Next up is the Desiccant bags. You need these for the AMS. They are absolutely critical for keeping your filament dry. You'll go through one every couple of weeks or two every couple of weeks, so if you keep a stock of them, they are useful. PTFE tubes. These ones are for the AMS, for inside the AMS. If you've seen my previous video, you've seen me dismantle the AMS for the Hydra AMS. These are spare PTFE tubes. They are consumable. They will wear away and you will need to replace them. Having a stock is a good idea and they're not too expensive. Now you can buy it this way or you can buy it this way. This one here is designed, or should I say, is aimed at replacing the tubes inside your printer, the longer tubes. But there's no reason why you can't buy this and then cut it down to size. If I take one of these small ones, bag is sealed. Just take one of these small ones. They're effectively the same tubing. So you don't need to buy the small pack. The advantage of the small pack is they're cut to size and you don't need to worry about it. If a tube wears out, just replace it. There's also this pack. So depending on your needs, you know, get whichever one you think is right for you. Next, a couple of smaller items. So these are the blades for your scraper. I don't think you need any extra. To be honest, I think using the metal scraper, which looks like this, is really not good for your bed. I've used this on the bed a couple of times and it's caused some problems. If you look at the bed, you can see lots of scratching and damage, and that's damage directly into the paint. So this bed really is end of life. Obviously you can replace the other side, which is the cold plate, and I'll get into that in a second. But this side here cannot be replaced on the engineering plate side. It's a paint coating or some form of coating. And it's got physical scratches from trying to scratch off the things, just catches. So those blades are not necessarily useful, but they do exist. So that's the blades for the scrapers. We also have the socks. So these again are consumables. They are for your hot ends. Basically put your hot end into it, and I think you should keep a stock of three of these. It's no harm having them. They're not that expensive, and if anything happens to the socks on your hot end, you can replace them quickly and get back up and printing. So definitely keep a few of those around. These cutters, so these are the cutters from the print head that cut the filament as it's retracting the filament back. They do need replacing. They are consumable. So definitely keep a stock of those. I've already replaced one. Had a lot of issues with filament not retracting properly, and it turned out the cutter was blunt and it wasn't cutting it properly. And this is the head cleaner. So this is the thing the head goes back and forth across to clean off excess filament. No harm keeping them. Again, they're silicon. They will wear away and they will need to be replaced. So having two or three of them handy is always a good idea. So I would recommend, if you can, get some of those.
Thanks for watching. In the second part, we'll go through print heads and print sheets. And again, please like, share, and subscribe. And see you in the next one.